Welcome to Laboratory 1, Discovering Diversity. Today you'll be learning how to estimate two aspects of diversity for one habitat. This will be an activity you complete at home, and we'll be showing you how. Before we begin, let's review a few concepts.
Okay, so for your first lab, you're going to be studying diversity. And so the question you should be asking yourself is, what is diversity? If you recall, in the pre-lab, diversity is made of two components, species richness and species evenness. So if you're asked on an exam, how would you define species richness or species evenness, what would you write? So if you recall, species richness is nothing more than the numbers of species present in the habitat. And species evenness is the number of individuals of each species in that habitat.
Recall the diversity index you learned in your pre-lab. Did you notice it took into account both species richness and species evenness? Species richness is taken into account by how many times you are multiplying those PI factors together. How is species evenness taken into account into that diversity index? For this lab, you will be going to a habitat of your choosing. It could be a park, a yard, even a sidewalk, and you're going to calculate the diversity index for that habitat. You will sample the habitat with either a transect or a quadrat. You'll count number of species and number of individuals. Using that data, you will calculate the diversity index and then do a rarefaction plot. So let's get started. As we've previously stated, we can sample habitats two different ways, transects or quadrats. In transects, we want to run a line through that habitat and take 8 samples along the line. This could be at regular intervals or random intervals. You can use rope, string, or even a USB cord as your transect. In a quadrat, we view the habitat as either a grid you can randomly select squares out of, or as an XY coordinate system in which you can use random numbers to determine where to take your sample. For your data collection, it is important to keep consistency in mind. If you decide on one size of sample, make sure that you use that same size for the rest of your samples. It's fairly easy to be consistent with your samples with just household items. A piece of paper trimmed into an empty square works just fine. Let's go ahead and take a sample. So we've decided to do a quadrat here, so this will be our x-axis, and here's our y-axis. So we have a random number table, and we have provided you with one as well. We've decided that this column is our x-coordinate, and this one is our y-coordinate. One thing we still need to decide on, though, is units. For a small planner, we might recommend centimeters or inches. For a larger area like this one, we could use feet. If you don't have a measuring tool on hand, you can use a number of steps. This is what we will be doing. Whatever method you choose, just be consistent. So let's look at our random number table again. Our x-coordinate is 5, and our y-coordinate is 3. Starting at 0, we'll go 5 this way and 3 this way. So here we are. We place our sampling quadrat down, and this will be our first sample. Within this quadrat, we want to count the number of species and the number of individuals. We don't have to know the species name. We're going to give them a functional one known as an OTU, or operational taxonomic unit. So we'll call this thing green asparagus, and we have one of them. So in this sample, we have one green asparagus, and 2 of these green feathery things. Now, if we re-examine this one called green asparagus, you'll notice that it's made out of a lot of little leaves, and it's not really obvious whether or not this is one plant, or maybe it's a bunch of individuals. And that's something that you're going to run into as you sample. So for instance, if you're sampling on a lawn, maybe you'd think, do I count every blade of grass as an individual? Do I try to find where they connect? Or do I assign them a unit, such as 1 square inch being an individual? And that will really be up to you. Now back to our sample. We've established our OTUs. Now we just need to count the number of individuals for each OTU. So for green asparagus, we're going to count it as 1 individual. And for green feathery things, we have 2 individuals. And ta-da! We have our data for this practice sample. 7 more of these and we would have a complete set of data. Now that you know what to do, you can sample on your own. Be sure to watch the video on rarefaction plots after sampling and calculating your diversity index. If you have any questions, please contact your TA. Thank you for watching!